He was as light as a feather in his recognition that the world was changing and new times demanded new tactics. Thus, unlike the unrelenting caricature painted of him by a columnist in the Trinidad Express, suggesting that he was stuck in some outmoded 1960s notion of dependency theory, Norman was far lighter on his feet, seeking to understand the dynamics of globalization, the way in which it had dissolved some boundaries in communications and trade, but paradoxically reinforced them in labor and migration, but always searching for openings and strategies that would ultimately benefit the people of the South. Yet, He could also be as heavy as lead in the consistency of his advocacy for the poor and the powerless. There is a mantra running through his work, both written and praxis, and is to be found in his advocacy of a better deal for Caribbean minerals and an integrated Caribbean bauxite industry, for the full involvement of the Jamaican people in the formulation of the National Economic Plan, for the genuine transference of technology from the north to the south, so that we might become makers of our future instead of just consumers of consumables made elsewhere. Against the 60-odd year cruel Cuban embargo, against the egregious exclusion of Dominican-born Haitian descendants from legal status, making them stateless, for a better deal from the Europeans than offered in the EPA, in order for us to compete on a slightly more level playing field without hands tied behind our backs, and for a greater recognition of the tenuous position of small states in the contemporary world with the real possibility of existential crisis. Girvan's mantra through all these is that there must be an ethic that undergirds human relations, whether at the national or international levels, and at its essence must be the notion of justice. Justice for the poor, justice for the weak, justice for weak nations and states. This was Norman's constant theme, despite changes in tactics from the 70s until the present. Yet Norman was as light as a feather in his love for his family, for Jasmine, Ramon, Alexander, and Alatash, and his nurturing presence in their lives, made even more remarkable when placed alongside his peripatetic involvement in the social and political turbulence of the contemporary Caribbean. I shall never forget the poignant letter he shared, written to Alex, who was grappling with difficult exam topics, outlining the context and contours of his life and making history real and meaningful in a brilliant and unprecedented way. And light as a feather in his willingness to listen, speak, and work with a new generation of Caribbean activists, scholars, both at home and abroad. And through it all, he was as heavy as lead in his unwavering commitment to Caribbean regionalism and his refusal to abide within the confines of narrow, insular parochialism.